If you like offense, this was the game for you. Syracuse 89, NC State 82. I know you're thinking, how were that many points scored? Well, Ben Spector, Joe Puccio, they're going to have the answers for you right here on Orange Press Pass. We're breaking down the game on the offensive end, on the defensive end, everything you can possibly ask for right here on OTN. And it starts right now. Hello and welcome inside the CitrusTV studios with Ben Spector and Joe Puccio. I'm Brad Klein, and guys, 89-82, Syracuse needed this win in the worst way. It's their first time all season that they've paired consecutive ACC wins, and big monkey off their back, the first time that they've won a road game since December 4th. Joe, we'll start with you on first thoughts.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to go with the individual route here, and I think that Jesse Edwards is the anchor of this basketball team. Syracuse won tonight mainly because of Jesse Edwards and his role in the high post. But moving forward, I think Syracuse is going to win games because of Jesse Edwards or lose because he's not on the floor.
I'll take it a step further, Joe. This was the best game Syracuse has played all season. This is the best they've looked all year.
I mean,
it's no longer Buddy Boeheim relying on him to score. The offense is gelling together. Like you said, Jesse Edwards, Cole Swider, Jimmy Boeheim, Joe Girard. The offense is gaining chemistry, and we saw it here tonight against NC State.
All right, so Ben Spector is saying that this might actually be the best version of Syracuse basketball that we've seen all year. If you don't believe him, well, let's just roll the highlights and see if he's telling the truth here. Syracuse and NC State, and Jim Boeheim said earlier this week, hey, I'm not doing a good enough job coaching this team. Well, Joe Girard saying, hey, coach, I got your back. 7-5 early, 2 minutes into the game, and then Girard teleporting to Jesse Edwards. That 1-2 pair, that was lethal for Syracuse all night, but NC State, they had a thing or two clicking on offense as well. 8 minutes in, Terquavion Smith the three, and Breon Pass just a couple minutes later off the bench. That was his only field goal of the day. A 6-point lead for NC State, 6 minutes left in the first. Bang, Buddy Boeheim, he was really strong. Volume shooter, we'll get to that later, but Terquavion Smith in the waning seconds of the first half puts NC State up by three. We go to the second, and Buddy Boeheim again. He was 6 for 16. The percentage not great, but when Syracuse needed him, they got him. And this is when you knew, hey, Syracuse, their offense, they're just really good tonight. This is their night. Jimmy Boeheim picking up the crumbs in the corner, and Joe Girard from the parking lot. My goodness, is this even the same player that we saw in Pittsburgh who was really struggling, 1 of 12 from the field? I don't think so, but Jalen Gibson reinvented himself too. 14 points, career high. But when Buddy Boeheim's doing this, and when Cole Swider is doing that, it's going to be really tough for NC State to keep up, even with Jalen Gibson in his first career start having a career night. In Syracuse 89, NC State 82. The Orange needed it probably worse than NC State did. Joe, how did they do it?
I think Syracuse had that balance offensively. All five starters had scored in double figures tonight. It's been Syracuse's MO all season long, but tonight was evident. They needed effort and input from everybody in that starting lineup, and it worked well for Syracuse tonight.
Syracuse has struggled in the second half all season long, and in the second half tonight, they came out firing on all cylinders. They were perfect from the floor to start the half, 11 of 11, and shot over 70% from three. Are you kidding me? You're not losing many games when you shoot over 70% from three in a half. The shooting numbers were out of this world.
Yeah, I feel like Ben Spector's got the Casio solar-powered calculator just to tell us, hey, what numbers are good and what numbers are bad. I'll tell you this much. The defensive numbers were bad. The offensive numbers were good. We're just getting started here on Orange Press Pass, breaking down everything you need to know about Syracuse's 89-82 dub in Raleigh. An 82 win for Syracuse over NC State. And we've got everything you need to know here on Orange Press Pass with Joe Puccio, Ben Spector. I'm Brian Klein. And if you missed the game, we've got you covered. We'll fill you in. If you saw the game, here's what you didn't see. Joe Puccio, you're going to tell me, I'm going to ask you a question here. You got to tell me straight up, yes or no. Is this the best that we've seen the Syracuse offense?
It's up there. I'd like to argue potentially yes. This was an unreal offensive performance from Syracuse. And if they had nothing close to the performance they had tonight, NC State would walk home victorious probably by at least 15 or 20.
Wow. I mean, this offense was the best it has looked all season, like you had said. I mean, Joe Girard, Jesse Edwards, they were firing on all cylinders. And I think what we see from Syracuse a lot is that we see a lot of three-point shooting, you know, between Buddy Boeheim and Joe Girard, but we saw a lot of Jesse Edwards on the inside, a lot of assists from Joe Girard, and we see it in a play that I found in the second half, where Jesse Edwards had a pick and roll, and Joe Girard had the ball at the top of the key, and it was just, the shooters were spread out. And I think that you see it right here. Joe Girard dribbling at the top. Jesse Edwards set a screen. Stop it right there. Buddy Boeheim, Jimmy Boeheim, the brothers, are out on one wing, spaced out the floor. The two defenders dragging them out wide. Cole Swider at the bottom, the defender dragging him out wide. So a little two-man game up here. We don't really see that from Syracuse a lot this season. Girard takes the screen, finds Jesse Edwards inside, bang, 2 points. It extends the lead by double digits.
I like that roll, too, on the right side of that alley. I think Jesse Edwards had some prime real estate to get some buckets in.
I agree. I mean, Jesse really showed out tonight, and so did Joe Girard.
Yeah, guys, that's all well and good. The offense was really working, and I mentioned before in the highlights, right, Joe Girard, Jesse Edwards, that 1-2 punch, that's something that we really haven't seen much of from Syracuse. But, Spector, got to flip the script here because the price of admission for such a good offense tonight, it was a really, really tough defense. Is this a new low for the 2-3 zone?
Absolutely. The defense was horrendous tonight. I mean, yes, the offense was great, like we had talked about before, 89-82 victory, but the defense was just sloppy. They were slow on rotations. Cole Swider, Jimmy Boeheim, they looked lost. I mean, Jimmy Boeheim looked the most lost he has looked all season long. He grew up with the 2-3 zone. Jim Boeheim's his father. You think he transferred from Cornell. He fit right in. He doesn't. They're 22 games into the season, and he just looks completely, I don't know where he is out there.
Now, those slow rotations, I believe they come from over-pursuiting, and we're going to check out a play right here where I felt like Syracuse's defense got a little bit too aggressive. So we check out this play right here. NC State utilizes the high post to get the ball down to the low block. What is Jimmy doing here? He's triple teaming a guy on the block. Frank and Cole are there. This guy in the corner is wide open. This pass gets out to the corner. Look, he's like running back. You see his head go down. He doesn't get to that corner in time. NC State gets another three-pointer on the board, over-pursuing, a little too aggressive on defense. SU just needs to simplify this moving forward.
He just seems unaware of what's going on.
It could be a Jimmy problem, could be a team problem.
Too focused on the ball, though. You know what I mean? He needs to focus on what's moving around him. The off-ball movement was key, and he just wasn't focused on it tonight.
All right, so Doc Pucci, you've got your stethoscope on the flatlining heart that is the 2-3 zone right now. So that's the prognosis. What's the cure here?
Now, I'm not going to go with anything too crazy, shifting formations, bringing in different players.
Okay.
I'm swapping players.
It's a one-for-one.
Jimmy to the top, Buddy to the bottom.
That's crazy.
Now, it's not that crazy.
That's crazy.
Because I'll tell you why.
That's crazy.
The wing should have the most athletic players in that 2-3 zone.
Never.
Benny Williams and Buddy Boeheim, they are the two most athletic players. So why not put them down low? Is it because Buddy's a guard? I don't believe so. If you put Jimmy up top, that puts a lot of height alongside of Joe Girard that can contest those three-pointers. And Buddy can get to the corner, just like on that play we just saw. Buddy Boeheim can contest that shot. So just switch the brothers.
A 2-inch height difference can make a big difference. I don't know. I think that Syracuse should go to the 1-3-1 or the 1-1-3 more often. I'm going to go a little more complex.
1-1-3,
It seems like it's a last resort. And it works. It keeps the ball out of the high post when teams go to that high post, attack it in the 2-3 zone, because Buddy Boeheim and Joe Girard are dropping at the top. So why not? I want to see more 1-3-1, 1-1-3.
You're asking for three-point shooting.
NC State was shooting the ball all the time when Buddy Boeheim moved to that middle and defended the high post. They weren't hitting their shots.
Not every team's going to shoot like NC State
did. Yeah, but I mean, a lot of teams are going to shoot the same amount of threes.
Well, hey, defending the high post with that 1-1-3 means that you're going to have to really bite the bullet there on the three-point shooting, right? So, and that's something that Syracuse really had to deal with early on in the season when they were using that alternative zone a lot more. So I don't know, Spector, it's easier said than done, I'll put it that way. But I will say this, over the past few minutes, we're talking about Syracuse basketball and their struggles on defense and their struggles as a whole. They give up 82 points. That's not a good number. You still win, that's fine. But if we're not talking about you over the past few minutes, you're probably doing something right. So it's time for Orange Press Pass Player of the Game. We've got to brainstorm here, guys, because all five starters scored in double figures. Who do you think? Let's just throw out some names. Brainstorm. No idea is a bad idea. What do you think?
The first player that comes to my head is Cole Swider. Yeah. He shot pretty well from the field today, but... what do you think, Spector?
Joe Girard, I mean, 8 assists, playmaker, you know, 1 turnover. He's had a lot more turnovers than assists in games in the past, and 8 assists, 1 turnover. That assist-to-turnover ratio is pretty darn good.
I don't know. Joe Girard's a fine pick, but you might want to go with his Thunder buddy, right? Jesse Edwards, that 1-2 punch, 19 points, 8 of 9 shooting today. My vote's Jesse. What do you guys think?
I think you've put me some time away, Brad. I'm gonna go with Jesse.
I agree. I did not think of Jesse Evans.
It's all right. Hey, Pooch gets it. He knows how to get on my good side. Yeah, for sure. Okay, so Jesse Edwards, we've established Orange Press Pass Player of the Game. Again, 19 points, 8 of 9 shooting. He was fantastic. And guys, this was his best offensive performance over the past month. You have to go back to the Miami game.
It just seems like every single game he's getting better. I remember a few seasons ago, Jesse was averaging 2 points per game, felt like he was nowhere to be found. Then he breaks his career high in points twice. He shows up in ACC play this season. Jesse Edwards, man, he has been awesome for Syracuse this year.
This has to be a confidence booster for Jesse Edwards after his coach threw him under the bus just a couple days ago, saying that he can't play. 19 points, they're using him all over the floor offensively. A lot more trust in Jesse Edwards from Jim Boeheim. This was a great game for him, and he needed this one more than anybody on the team.
All right, guys, well, things are just heating up here on Orange Press Pass. On the other side of a quick break, we've got a temperature check for you. Is it Fahrenheit? Is it Celsius? None of the above. Spoiler alert, on the other end, you'll be surprised. Hear this?
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable. With you that time you felt most alone, and with you when you realized you would never be. They were with you when you shared your love with the world, and with you when she became your world. Your girls have never left you. They're still with you right now. How well do you know them? You don't know why. Knowing your breasts can save your life.
OTN is on all your favorite apps. Apple TV, Fire TV, and Roku. Search Orange Television Network or OTN. OTN has its best shows, short films, and CitrusTV on demand. Family and friends can watch OTN too. Watch the live stream of OTN to catch live CitrusTV news, live from Studio B, and mornings on the Hill. On or off campus, watch OTN anywhere.
There's been a lot of criticism surrounding Syracuse this season. The defense is horrendous, the second worst scoring defense in the ACC, and the Orange haven't been able to close out games. But one thing Syracuse fans can't complain about, that's the offense. SU has the fourth best scoring offense in the ACC this season, and that was on display tonight. Syracuse shot 59% from the floor, a season high, and the best mark in ACC play since 2018 against Boston College. Now, a lot of this is thanks to an offensive outburst in the second half. Syracuse came out of the break firing on all cylinders, converting on its first 11 shots. SU finished the frame shooting nearly 75%. Now, I get it. Syracuse as a whole is falling short of expectations. The Orange sit at 500, fighting an uphill battle to get into the NCAA tournament. After tonight, though, it's fair to say that the offense especially is exceeding expectations.
All right, numbers guru Ben Spector, and he's joined by Joe Puccio out of nowhere. Joe, where'd you go?
I was just chilling over there. This guy had a great monologue talking about the offense.
It was fine, but you probably got lonely over there.
I thought it was okay.
I just vanished. I actually came to the
wall. I thought it was better than off screen there. We'll talk about it after the show. With those two, I'm Brad Klein. Very happy to be with you, breaking down this 89-82 win for Syracuse, and they needed it in the worst way to break a five-game road skid, the longest since 2015. So guys, I mentioned before, we've got the temperature check, Celsius, Fahrenheit, none of the above. It's the OPP metric, whatever, just go with it, right? So we're gonna go temperature check. 10 is hot, 1 is not, and we'll start with Cole Swander. Joe, what do you think?
Yeah, first of all, I don't know where you're gonna find the OPP temperature scale online these days, but just stick with us here. Swander's hot. Swider's at an 8. I really like the performance from Cole Swider tonight. 16 points, was perfect from downtown. And I mentioned earlier how that inside-out sort of offensive performance was great for the Orange. Well, Cole Swider was the outside. And so I think that if Cole Swider can keep this performance going for games to come, yeah, he had 3 turnovers tonight, so that's why he's not at like the 9 or the 10. But big fan of Swider. If he can keep this thing going, he's the big transfer that Syracuse wanted.
You're going to get nitpicky about 3 turnovers?
Just a little bit.
Get your Bunsen burner out, all right?
Whoa.
It's a 10 on the OPP scale. The best 2-game stretch of Cole Swider's collegiate career, and tonight he was on fire. 7 of 9, 4 of 4 from beyond the arc. He looks more comfortable. He's getting to his spots. He's converting on looks. He had a play where he pump fake, took an extra dribble. We didn't see that at the beginning of the season. We see it now with the transfer from Villanova. He's getting comfortable in Jim Boeheim's system.
I don't know, the Bunsen burner thing kind of feels like a dig at Joe Puccio, right? Hey, how's the pinky from fourth grade, Joe?
Look, it's been a long time. Still mentally recovering, but physically
Cole
we're all right.
Slider,
yeah, Joe in school was one of the squares into circle peg teacher. It's not going. What's
right
going on there? Hey, but the bench wasn't helping Cole Slider out, so whatever grade you're giving him, it's got to be pretty darn impressive that he was doing it with pretty much no reserves behind him. And the reason, well, head coach Jim Boeheim, he's got you filled in.
I'd like to get something more out of our guys off the bench, but there's a struggle there. There's a real struggle there. So we'll see how it goes. But we're losing too much when we do go to those guys, and we can't lose when we go to those guys. They've got to be able to hold us in there.
Now, guys, this is nothing new. The bench struggles have been a motif all year. In fact, the Orange get 90% of its scoring from the starters, and today it was 100% with the bench going 0-for-1 as a unit. The three of them, Frank Anselm, Simir Torrance, Benny Williams, for the record, it was Benny who missed his one shot. So what is your temperature on the bench right now, Joe?
Look, I'm going to give it a 4 because it's tough to give this bench slack tonight. I mean, Coach Boeheim said that he doesn't trust them, but don't you trust the hot hands more? Like, I feel like we can't really dig the bench for what they did tonight because Syracuse's starters were just on fire. So the only reason why I'm giving it a 4 is because Benny Williams was just running down and back on the court. Like, he didn't score at all, didn't make that much of a difference, but that's why I'm going with a 4.
I guess I'm just more confident than you. I have a 2. I'm ice cold. It's cold in Syracuse. Cold. I mean, it's cold on the OPP scale. And the thing is, the bench is just too inconsistent. Frank Anselm played well against Wake Forest, but 3 fouls in 4 minutes tonight. You need consistency on your team. You get that from your starters, not from your bench. And only Simir Torrance, Benny Williams, Frank Anselm, not many options there. So just a 2 from me.
But how do you knock those guys? How do you knock those bench players for what Jesse and Cole Swider did?
That's the point, though, is that they can't live up to that. They can't be as consistent as that. You can't trust them in those situations.
Yeah, and Jim Boeheim not having much trust with the bench like you just heard a minute ago. And I'm still trying to figure out, by the way, what the boiling point is here on on the OPP temperature scale. We'll figure that later. Jim Boeheim, let's just flip the script right on him. Where are you right now on the temperature scale for the head coach?
I'm going to go with an 8 for Jim Boeheim. Pretty high on Coach Boeheim right now. Look, he gets a lot of flack, all right? Yes, he's been coaching here for a while, has a rigid, old-style form of basketball, but he just won 2 massive ACC games. And I think that once you get into February, March, that's when you need to win. That's when the season really starts. The Orange have some big-time games coming up. The Orange play like this, Coach Boeheim is going to be praised for it.
It's a 4. I mean, Jim Boeheim said the other day that he struggled as a coach this year. He's not proud of what he's done, and the defense is just horrendous. You are known for the 2-3 zone. Your team is known for the 2-3 zone. You have the second worst scoring defense in the entire conference. So defense wins championships, Joe. That's the
sure
cliche, and it's not winning Syracuse anything. They sit at 5-11. 500, they are 11 and 11 on the year, so a 4 from me.
All right, I guess it really just depends on what you're looking at. Ben's looking at the defense, and Joe, you're just sticking to the offense. I get it, but let's lump it all together. Joe, we'll start with you. Temperature on Syracuse as a team, Syracuse as a program this season.
I'm at like a 7. Like, we're just turning on the stove a little bit. Nothing too crazy. Just make sure we don't get any salmonella. I think that the Orange are in a pretty solid spot right now. Yes, the record's terrible, and they've had some bad losses on their resume. But it's not about looking back at the past. It's how you learn from it and move forward. And this win tonight for the Orange, as abysmal as the defense was, if that offense plays the way it does for the next handful of games, you never know.
That's a high ask. I'm giving a 4 again for similar reasons that I
so
gave Jim Boeheim before. I am, because look, the defense is just horrendous. And 22 games into the season, you should figure out your defense. You should have those rotations down. There should be no miscommunications. There are too many miscommunications against a middle-of-the-pack NC State team. So a 4
there.
From me. Nice. The Wolf Pack, yeah, the pack thing. You like what I did there?
Nice.
Play on words. It's a 4.
All right. So, Ben, yeah, you're pessimistic, I guess. So what does that make Joe, then? Optimistic? I'm kind of looking at, like, gold on the other side of the rainbow for Joe, and Ben, you're kind of jealous?
He's just Spector. That's just who he is.
I'm not jealous.
I don't know. Hey, Ben and Joe, they saved the best for last, because on the other side here on Orange Press Pass, we're getting their final thoughts. Don't turn the dial. 89-82 Syracuse wins, and we have a lot more here on Citrus TV.
Bedroom. Come on. Okay, Dad. 1, 2, 3. Dad! You saved me. Dad?
Are you okay?
I'm fine, dear.
Your hero needs you now, and AARP is here to help. Find the care guides you need at aarp.org/caregiving.
Did you hear about the pony with a sore throat? He was a little horse.
Can I tell you a cat joke? Just kidding.
Why was the basketball court all wet?
Why?
Because the players kept dribbling all over it.
Where do cats go on vacation?
New York.
Welcome back on the bench with Joe Puccio and Ben Spector. I'm Brad Klein. Syracuse 89, NC State 82. That was a good result for the Orange. Not the only result around the nation. Let's check it out. Here are other scores going on, including the ACC here. And how about that? Wake Forest after that loss to Syracuse, leaving no doubt over Pittsburgh. 91-75. Alondis Williams, he's hard to stop, and he's a 3-level scorer, too.
He certainly is. The one game that I'm looking at, Brad, Miami losing by 4 on the road in South Bend. Miami is like one of those good teams in the ACC up there with Duke. They lost a tough one.
And Clemson beat Florida State. Florida State and Syracuse split the series, and Syracuse completely demolished Clemson. So that's an interesting score to look at. Only won by 6 points.
All right, so those are the scores. What are the implications? Let's check out the standings. Where does Syracuse lie? Well, in a way, you're going to have to squint. It's not going really well for Syracuse. Duke, Notre Dame, Miami coming out of nowhere. They were picked towards the bottom in the preseason polls, but the Hurricanes, ever since that 18-point comeback over Syracuse in Coral Gables, they've just been a different team.
And Syracuse will see Miami on March 5th inside the Dome. It'll be a good one inside the Carrier Dome, but I don't know what to expect from Syracuse then. I mean, it's an up and down season. Miami's having a great season. We'll see what happens.
I said this earlier. Syracuse has some big games coming up. Look at number 1 and look at number 4. You can even look at number 3 if you want.
I did.
Syracuse plays 3 of the top 4 teams in the ACC coming up. This is big for the Orange.
All right, so those are the standings. That's where Syracuse lies. Here's what's next. It's Louisville, and the Orange offense is going to play really well. That's what the stats project, but the Louisville offense is playing pretty well, too. Not Syracuse level, but the Cardinals can still score. And they're having some tangled complications with the head coaching spot. Chris Mack is out, so it's definitely a Cardinal team that's trying to figure some things out.
Yeah, and the offense is sort of wishy-washy as well. Malik Williams is the only player in double digits per game for the Cardinals, and he has 10 on the nose. So Louisville is in a bit of a rut, and Syracuse can take advantage of it.
You see it on your screen there. The Cardinals are on a 4-game losing streak. Syracuse on a 2-game winning streak. They need to take advantage of that opponent because Syracuse needs to start stacking wins in the ACC in order to compete in March.
Final thoughts on the 89-82 win for Syracuse. Joe, we'll start with you.
I'm going to take a pessimistic route, even though I was optimistic earlier.
Flip the script.
Stronger defense is needed. I think if Syracuse's offense plays the way it does for the rest of the season, boy, they could go anywhere they want. But that defense will be a hindrance for them. And I think if they change some things up, as you mentioned with the formation, or by switching Jimmy and Buddy, I think Syracuse's defense can help them win.
So you might want a formation change.
We're going to flip
the script even more. Build on the momentum. Syracuse, 2 wins in the ACC. Consecutive wins in the ACC, haven't had a win streak longer than 2 games this season, so potentially make it 3 against Louisville, and an outstanding offensive performance from all 5 starters. Build on that against Louisville.
Yeah, not necessarily anything new that Syracuse gets a balanced scoring attack from all 5 starters. One of just 2 teams in the nation that has all 5 starters averaging double figures. And we were talking about it before the show. It's not necessarily because, hey, this team is something special offensively, but because the bench is still borderline absent from the box score. We'll see if that changes against Louisville. To find out, just follow us on Twitter at CitrusTV Sports. Check out OTN for our next Orange Press Pass. We got other shows too on Citrus TV. By the way, Instagram, Citrus TV Sports. We also have a TikTok, Citrus TV. Wow. _. That's right. Yeah, TikTok. Give it some love. Thanks so much.